Yeah, we are alive. You and I hope you are alive too, my dear viewers. And today, like you see, we have a wonderful sunny day in Poland. And you know what? Of course, I have next wonderful book for you. I know maybe you have a better idea. Maybe you want to go somewhere, but of course you can go somewhere with your favorite book. Why not? Today, Isaac Asimov and the Positronic Man. Why I've chosen this book for today? Because last week I have read interesting information. I don't know, it's like something new, or maybe it's not like completely new idea, but in Asian country, they have wonderful idea, probably for them, like avatars on television. Just imagine, you don't need to try to prepare contract for your next television star. You don't need to worry about their salary or something like that, because you just have avatars. And right now, artificial intelligence try to learn how to be the best presenter ever. I avoid to say journalist because I think it's not like a real journalist if someone's not really understand what about they want to talk. Okay, you can say that same with people. I completely agree. Right now, something like journalist, it's really rare. And it's really rare to find independent source of knowledge or information. Usually, someone pays for that, and it's not like completely independent. And you know, usually when you think about something, you made your decision, what you think, and after that you try to find a good argument why you think in this way, not in opposite way or something like that. And I think it's still just challenging and something what we have the opportunity to do is just agree for different sources of information, and sometimes we have like balance. They say yes, they say no, and it's your decision. What's better for you? What do you believe? But of course, it's more problematic, like right now, when so many people don't follow knowledge, don't follow scientists, because they don't believe scientists no more. They believe last singer from last songs, it's more intelligent and know much more than, for example, professors or doctors or another people. And usually I ask them, okay, if you have a real trouble with your health, please tell me, who will risk their life for you? This singer, are you sure? Or maybe this doctors and the scientists who right now for you not really like authority. And you know, if you think about your life and life another people, do you think it's exactly the same value for you? Or maybe all the time you think your life is more important, or you are more intelligent than another people or something like that. If you think like that, probably you have problem. Yeah, maybe you are a little too narcissistic or something like that. And if we just return to our concept like avatar on TV. Okay, they never have bad mood. They never want better contract. They never have problem with face because they don't need lifting, they don't need Botox. They can smile, they can react like almost every person. Yeah, I think because usually this company who created idea like television, what about they thought? Money. Oh yeah, and in this case it will be more profitable then real human star with so many different wishes about everything. Okay, but we'll see. It will be our future when you just turn on your television and you have, wow, your favorite avatar. And next questions. Usually, when we are taught about our future, do you think who look after you, who take care of you in your future? Because if you share with your children, with another people, idea about independent, about selfish, about don't care about another people, money first or something like that, I want to only ask you, okay, what do you want to do in the future if you will be old, but you know, extreme situation, no money and you are just old. You have only one possibility. You know, we have something like invest in concept of special tools to suicide. But I think it's really pity if we think about how many new technology we are able to improve, how many new things we are able to create it, but all the time our old minds talked only about killing. What's wrong with us? And something really interesting. Isaac Asimov prepared this book, The Positronic Man, like the last position. And it's like compilation he's thought about the first, the second novel. And it's really interesting because all the time we know it's not a problem with artificial intelligence. It's all the time problem with people, with our mindset. If you want to create better future, better artificial intelligence, we should start with us, with our mindset. And probably if this version from this book will be the true, the robots, the androids, artificial intelligence try to follow logic, rational. But you know, people aren't rational. You only think you are rational. But like Richard Feynman said, if you are not like expert from your area or something like that, we are all silly. We are all stupid in different way. And if we understand that problem, I think we will be ready to prepare something much better than only copy-paste artificial intelligence. Thank you so much for your time. 8 minutes. And I just talk in English all the time. You know what's really funny? I talk all the time. When you know something more, you are more confusing with something. Okay, and I was talking with Otavio yesterday, and I have that funny situation when I try to explain something in Spanish, but it was so hard for me because I'm like total beginners, and I have this brilliant thought, oh my God, maybe we start to talk in English because it's much more easier for me right now. And you know, if you are struggling with something, maybe it's a good idea to start to learn something new. And after, when you try to compare this older and new knowledge, you know, yeah, I know so many things from something else. And it's just great feeling. And you know, every day is a good possibility to know something more. And please follow scientists, follow people who really try to understand and people who don't tell you, I know everything because it's really dangerous. Sometimes people try to share idea. Yeah, I know everything. Nobody know everything. All the time, we should use this something, you know, inside. Inside, probably, you have these brilliant tools, your brain, and just try to use and ask yourself. Don't believe people who try to share story. I know everything. I am a brilliant politician. I am brilliant something else. Not really. And please, don't follow stupidity, because in this case, democracy is not a good idea. Thank you so much. Take care and bye-bye.